The QALY is a key outcome in health economic evaluation. It's what we call the unit of health, like weight is expressed in kilograms and length is expressed in centimeters or inches. Well, in exactly the same way, we express health in the number of QALYs that can be gained with the treatment. And a QALY combines two elements, quality of life and life expectancy. So imagine the patient has a life expectancy of 10 years, but the quality of that life, which can be expressed between 0 and 1, 1 would be perfect health and 0 would be death, and imagine that this patient is somewhere in between, so that patient has a quality of life of 0.5 on that scale between 0 and 1, and imagine that patient will live during 10 years at a quality of only 0.5, then we say this patient has 5 QALYs, 5 quality adjusted life years. 10 years in perfect health would be 10 QALYs, but 10 years in only half the health is then only 5 QALYs. Imagine now there is a fantastic new treatment and the treatment can cure that patient from that very severe disease with that very short life expectancy and also poor quality of life. Then suddenly it might turn into a situation of a life expectancy of 70 years in perfect health. And then we have 70 QALYs. 70 years in perfect health would be 70 QALYs. Even if that life is not perfect, 70 years at a quality of only, let's say, 0.8, then we still have a lot of QALYs. 70 times 0.8, which is 56. And but it means that many treatments have the potential to gain a lot of QALYs, either by improving the quality of life of the patient, which we see, for instance, in Crohn's disease or in chronic pain or in arthritis. There it's not about extending the life of the patient, but it's improving the quality of life for the remaining life of a patient. And by doing so, we can gain a lot of QALYs. But if you can have an impact on both the life expectancy and the quality of life, then of course you can gain a lot of QALYs.